Okay, here's a practice problem in graphing quadratic equations or parabolas in standard form, in this case. And we also have vertex form, so we'll do one of those. So you can hopefully you got this grid off my site, my classroom site. And on this one, we're going to have to expand it a little bit because it actually comes off this grid. So you're going to have to draw some lines. So I just used a ruler and drew some vertical lines and lined them up and some horizontal lines like this. So you can do that with a pencil and use a ruler so you get straight lines. And then extend this all the way down to negative 13, so you can kind of eye these so these are the same distance. They don't have to be exactly right, so just get as close as you can possibly get and draw some vertical lines. So draw a little extended grid like this, and this is what we're going to use, okay? And then we're going to need this a little bit later, so you could also put this down if you want. The square root of 9 is 3, the square root of 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, the square root of 16 is 4. You could draw that over there if you want also, because we're going to use that, okay? And now what you can do is, after you have this all set up, you can pause the video, then try to answer as many of these questions as you can and draw the graph and do your work in pencil in case you make a mistake. And then you can restart the video and then you can see the solution. So right now, pause it and then do the work and then restart it and let's see how much you got right. So good luck. Okay, hopefully you hit pause, you tried the problem, and you hit play. So you can practice, okay? So let's see how much of this we can fill out. Now, first of all, since this is positive, we know this is going to be shaped like a U, so that means it's going to open up, so that's going to be easy, okay? All right, we want to find the vertex. So this is in standard form, so we've got to use our good old x equals minus b all over 2a. So a in this case is going to be 1, and b will be 6. So x equals minus b all over 2a, so that will equal negative 6 over 2 times 1, which is 2, so that's just going to be negative 3. So that means my vertex, be the form, negative 3 will be the x value, and then I have to find the y value. It's negative 3 something, and how do I find the y value? Well, I put that back in the function. It tells me right up here, y equals something squared plus 6 times something, minus 4, and my something is going to be negative 3. So I'll put the negative 3 in here, and that's going to be 9, minus 18, minus 4. 9 minus 18 is negative 9, and negative 4 is negative 13. So my vertex, my y value is negative 13, and that's why we needed the extended grid. So if I put my vertex in, negative 3, 1, 2, 3, negative 13 is going to be right over here. So there's your vertex. So my vertex is at negative 3, negative 13. This is the x and this is the y. So there's your axis of symmetry. X equals negative 3, pardon me. And the maximum minimum, well, since it's shaped like a U, we're going to have a minimum, so you can circle that, and the minimum is going to be the y value at the vertex, negative 13. Okay, so that's going to be our minimum. It's open up, excuse me. Now you can, the y-intercept's very easy. The y-intercept is just going to be when x is 0, so when x is 0, we have the y-intercept. And when y is 0, we have the x-intercepts. If we have x-intercepts, and in this case we do. So I can just put 0 in for the x, and this is what y is going to be. So if I put 0 in for the x, 0, 0, negative 4, y will be negative 4. So that's easy to find. Standard form, the y-intercept is easy to find. Okay? And I could actually put that point in, 0, negative 4. I also could put my axis of symmetry, which is going to be negative 3. And we use a dashed line for that. And there you go. And we know we have a symmetrical point from on the other side of this intercept. So we go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And this is going to be a symmetrical point here. And the coordinates of that point would be negative 6, negative 4. Now we have to find our x-intercepts. That's the last thing over here. And that's going to be when y is 0. So we have to set this equal to 0. So we can do that over here. X squared plus 6x minus 4 equals 0. Hopefully we can factor it, but in this case we can't, so we're going to have to solve that quadratic equation by completing the square. This is a good candidate for completing the square because the coefficient on the x squared is 1, and this is an even number. So we're talking to complete the square. Okay, so we'll move the 4. So we got x squared plus 6x equals 4. Add 4 to both sides, and then the square root of x squared is x, and half of 6 is 3. 3 squared is 9, so I'm going to add 9 to both sides. And now we have that x plus 3 squared equals 13. So that means that x plus 3 equals plus or minus the square root of 13. And if I subtract, x equals negative 3 plus or minus the square root of 13. Now what's the square root of 13? Well, we can approximate. We know that the square root of 9 is 3, and the square root of 16 is 4, and 13 is in between. So I wrote all my possibilities here. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and I counted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there's 7 increments. Half of 7 is 3.5. 1, 2, 3.5. That's my halfway point. So the square root of 13 should be a little bit more than halfway between 3 and 4. This is called interpolation. So we could say it's about 3.6. And I looked this up on my calculator, and that's pretty doggone close. So we could say plus or minus 3.6. So x and equal, and negative 3 plus 3.6, or negative 3 minus 3.6, let's do that one. That's negative 6.6, and minus 3.6. I'm sorry, plus. That was minus. Well, 3.6 minus 3 is just 0.6. So those are your intercepts. So I can put these in over here. Minus 6.60 and positive 0.6. And those are your intercepts. So we have to use completing the square and that approximation. I've showed you how to do that in class already. So that's a nice technique to know if you don't have a calculator. Okay. And so we can put these in. So this is going to be negative 6.66, so a little bit past the halfway mark, and then 0.6, a little bit halfway past the halfway mark there. So there's your 5 points. And now you can graph your parabola. Get a pretty good idea what's going on here. Make a nice smooth curve. Go through those intercepts, and there you go. You got 5 good points. Okay. And just do it in pencil, kind of connect it to get, so you get a nice smooth curve. The domain, well, the domain is going out in both directions, so it's negative infinity to infinity. And I look at my endpoints here, and I know I'm going up towards infinity, so my range will look like this part of the domain. Okay. And the right part of the range, because it's going up to infinity, and the left part is always a bracket, and it's going to be my minimum value, my y value, negative 13. So there's your range. Now we just asked for some points, so we're going to put the vertex in here. So the vertex was negative 3, negative 13. And then we put our y-intercept, which was negative, or 0, negative 4. That was the y-intercept. And the symmetrical point to that was the negative 6, negative 4. So that's a symmetrical point. So we found that by using the axis of symmetry. And then my x-intercept, the one on the left was negative 6.60, and the one on the right of the axis of symmetry was 0.60. And notice how you have your symmetry around the vertex. Here's negative 13 and negative 40, negative 40. So we want those 5 points. So there you go. So that's it in a nutshell. A lot of work. So if you didn't get it, kind of practice it and try it again. And you can stop this video and replay it and make sure you understand how we did every little aspect of this. So this would be worth a lot of points if it's a question, because there's lots of things you got to answer. Okay? Hope that helps.